about done, so we can add the chicken back into it. Doesn't that look good? It looks too gorgeous right now. Now we're just really waiting on the noodles there. Okay, done. I'm gonna turn this off. Okay, noodles are ready. We're gonna take this over here. Sure. The tray all the way. Add it to the rest of everything else. I'll mix it. Mix it. Doesn't that look scrumptious? I think so. Now while the noodles are hot, we really can't go ahead and get a tomato paste. The tomato paste in here. You might have to add a little salt to it. Not too much. Too much could be overkill. Like if you use like kosher salt, if you use kosher salt is already pretty strong, so a little would be nice. Don't overkill and give people heart attacks. That's not nice. So so take a little salt, like so. And a little bit of that meat. Not too much. Look at those colors. Like, the colors are really nice. I wish I could hold it up, but the bowl's a little too hot. Type person, I really like a lot of garlic, so more the merrier. If you don't, then it was really kind of optional. I kind of smell the garlic in it. It's really good. Okay. And now we want to go over here to our dish. Take this with me. I'm going to take this like so. Pour it into this. Get a little bit of some peanut. Cover all of them. scrumptious. Garlic. Now we're gonna take our cheese, scatter it over like that. I'm that type of person that I love, love, love cheese. Oh my gosh. Like, we should get married because I love that much cheese. Now it looks to me like I'm gonna need some more cheese. Make sure all of this is covered. You don't want any uncovered spots. And this really like was like a recipe for like you can make for 4 people, you can make up to 6 people, as well as, you know, for big gatherings that you have, but I made like a personal, like 2 people can eat off of this. Like, go ahead and add the rest of this in. The more cheese, the better. And then get the ooziness in it. You know, it's all nice. And now you can just take. Like for garnish, as far as like to make it look pretty, just take a little bit of the basil leaves, go across it like that. That looks fancy. Okay, now I'm gonna take it, put it in here for about 5 to 10 minutes, depends on how you would like the cheese to melt. Trust me, that's gonna come out really nice. That was really good. I'm ready. So, 5 to 7 minutes, maybe. And that's it. This is what you should have. Chicken Italia with bow tie pasta. Also, as well, like I said on the plate service suggestion, you can have garlic toast, you can have a nice side salad with Italian dressing. You should really try with the salad, it's really, really good together. Hey, I enjoy making it. I hope you yourself will enjoy making this as well. Or you can find me at myspace.com/Chardonnay's Cafe. You can also find me on my twitter.com/chef_name. And you can also find me at youtube.com/Chardonnay's Cafe as well. So, voila, where we cater to you with elegance.